Well, we're back on duty with the Vice in half an hour. First on ITV1. Now, be honest with me. Would you want your kids redesigning your house?
Hello and welcome once again to Home on Their Own, the show in which parents do the unthinkable. They allow their children to redesign the family home. And this is what happens.
Oh my God!
What on earth have they done?
Oh my God!
He'd probably have a nervous breakdown on the spot.
It's probably my worst nightmare come true.
This week, we're in the village of Inglesthorpe in Norfolk, home to another family of creative children and brave, trusting, if not foolish, parents. Let's meet the Carmen family.
I was a bit worried. I woke up at 5 a.m. and thought, I must be mad. What am I doing? It's too late now anyway, isn't it?
They think that I have never been a child myself. Probably by letting them do this, it might just give them an inkling that I have got, still got a sort of kind of a sense of humour, and you know, and I'm not totally boring grown up, which I think I am.
When Andy's not at home being dad, he's on the road, living the rock and roll lifestyle as tour manager for Status Quo. His three children think he's too strict and things need to be a bit more rock and roll at home.
Dad's really boring and he doesn't let us do anything.
Well, I don't really mind how far we go as long as it like really annoys our dad and wrecks it for him.
Sometimes I think he's angry, this time I really think he's going to freak out.
It's too late for any second thoughts now. Andrew and Sheena are about to head off to a country house hotel 30 miles away while the kids take over.
OK then, right, see you later.
Bye.
Have fun. Not too much, all right?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
See you then.
Bye.
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 That's it. They're off.
Bye.
Come on then. You know what this means? It's playtime.
Come on.
Natalie, Nicola, and Matthew now have 2 days without mum and dad. It's time for the team to move in. They're led by design diva Kerry and gadget guru Jem. They'll use all their creative skills to make the ideas inside the kids' heads a reality. So, should mum and dad be worried?
My biggest fear is that the outside of the house at the front has turned into like an amusement arcade with lots of flashing lights and objects on it. I really couldn't bear that.
All right then, tell me what your plans are for the front of the house.
We want to like turn it into a Hollywood house.
A Hollywood house?
Yeah, because you want it to look like the outside of a film premiere.
A film premiere on your front doorstep?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, and we're going to have a red carpet and a big gate.
Yeah, and the big sign.
A big sign? What kind of sign?
It's going to look the style of the Hollywood sign. It's going to say Carmen Wood or something like that.
So why do you want it to look like a film premiere set?
Because it'd be really glitzy and glamorous. Mum and Dad hate anything like that. They like us to blend in with all the neighbours. And so we want it to be really, really different because Dad will just hate it. He hates any attention or anything.
Okay, Matthew, the kitchen. What's the plans for in here?
Well, my dad always makes me eat vegetables that I don't like. Peas are the worst, carrots are the second, broccoli is the third. I hate peas 3 times over.
You really do hate peas?
Yeah, I wouldn't eat one if someone said, I'll give you £1 million.
So what do you plan doing about it, Matthew?
Well, I want a gadget to get rid of my vegetables, like a tube. I just drop them down to the fruit, the dog bowl.
But what if the dog doesn't like vegetables?
Oh, they do. They eat anything.
Do they?
Yeah.
Even broccoli?
Yeah.
Next is the children's bedrooms and a cunning plan to stay up late at night.
Well, we get quite fed up because my dad, always, when he gets back, he always sends to bed earlier than we think we should go to bed.
So what do you want to do about it?
Oh, we want to turn
that room, which is my room, into like a den, and I'm going to move in here with Natalie, and we're going to make it really secret.
A secret den?
Yeah.
How?
Well, we're going to have holes in the wall, and to cover them up, we're going to like put posters and wardrobes in front of it, so they'll know about the den, but they won't actually know how we get into it.
That means you don't have to go to bed early and you can play all night.
Yeah.
So the front of the house is going to be transformed into something more Beverly Hills than Norfolk Fens. Meal times will never be the same with the new gadget to feed Matthew's unwanted vegetables to the dogs. And finally, Nicola's bedroom is going to become a den, complete with all mod cons and sealed off by a new wall replacing those French windows. What Mum and Dad won't know is that the girls will be able to sneak into the den after lights out via a concealed hole in the new wall. Matthew will be able to join them from his room by going through an entrance hidden behind a new wardrobe. So, let the work begin.
Thank you.
At a hotel far, far away, Mum and Dad are questioning their kids' intentions.
The children think that it's one of the best opportunities they're ever going to get one over on me. And I think probably half of them is actually saying, right, what can we do that will really annoy Dad?
Well, I wouldn't mind just going having a peep. A pair of binoculars from the field opposite, just to have a look.
And this is what she would see. Natalie is about to get stuck in the front garden, while outside the kitchen wall, preparations for the vegetable disposal chute are underway.
Right, you know your food tube?
Yeah.
That's going to take it outside to the dog,
yeah.
Relieving you of your peas. This is the machine here. You're going to have your secret tray, okay?
Yeah.
You can pop in your unwanted sprouts, peas, that kind of thing, yeah? Then you slide your tray in, it clicks onto this magnet here that holds it, and when you let go...
Are you ready?
That drops there and your boot goes in.
Yeah!
Outside the front door, it's time for Natalie to make the first impression in the Carmarthenwood Walk of Fame.
You could be there a while. In fact, I'll leave you there. I'll come back in a few minutes, all right?
Inside, Matthew and Nicola begin knocking through the bedroom wall.
Oh, that's a good shot.
Well, I just like the house the way it is. I like it inside as it is, so, you know, I don't really want sort of walls knocked out.
Perry? Yeah, it's still really, really runny. I don't know, it's still really, really runny.
No, I'll have to leave you a bit longer then.
Yay! Great shot!
One brick out!
Yay! Yeah. Stop, very gentle.
Good girl!
Yeah! Yeah!
Watch out!
Yay!
Yeah.
That was absolutely brilliant.
One finger at a time.
Oh, Mum and Dad can't move this then.
They certainly can't. Do you feel like a Hollywood star now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But Hollywood holds no appeal for Mum and Dad.
I'm not a big fan of films particularly, to be honest.
We like films and stuff. We like watching them on TV. But my dad hates films.
People like Hugh Grant and stuff like that just go straight over there.
Kick it.
Mum and Dad wouldn't be laughing if they could see what was happening inside the house. The new wall is up and work has begun on the secret entrances to the den.
I now want to go back and see what's going on. Or a clue. Just a little clue would be nice.
Your wish is our command. But remember, always be careful what you wish for.
Having a smashing time, loving the lovely kids, Nick, Matt and Matthew. Okay. What do you think it is?
Oh.
Oh my God. Where's that from?
Oh well, you know it's fairly extreme then.
What on earth have they done?
Oh, God.
Oh, God. It's day two, and the girls are in charge of spelling out the Carmenwood sign.
Can I just spell Carmenwood? Not random cow.
I'm not being personal, are you?
Right, come on, let's get this ordered into the right order.
If Mum and Dad could see what we were doing to their house now, oh my God, I don't know what Dad would do. He'd probably have a nervous breakdown on the spot.
Right, that's it.
Mum would probably either cry or scream.
She would put in the most evil concoction of vegetables. Yeah. Tinned cabbage, in it goes. Yeah. That's about as evil as vegetables get.
Yeah, right. That's fine.
Do you want to slide it in there and we'll test it? I'm quite nervous.
Yeah, we are quite nervous.
Is that all the way in?
Yeah, that's clicked, I think.
Right, okay, give it a go then.
Right, it's in. Right.
Okay.
It doesn't work.
Matthew, you hold there. I'm going to go and see what it is.
Jem should know by now. Never trust a 6-year-old boy.
It's working now.
Oh. Oh. Well, it does at least seem to work now, anyway. So that's the good news.
Bean bags and a parachute canopy are put into place in the den. A combination lock is being fitted to the only door to keep out unwanted parents. And the kids have a plan to fool the parents into thinking they're still asleep in bed. Life-size dummies.
We're going to have life-size dummies made of ourselves and we're going to put them in our pyjamas and put them into our beds just before we go into the den. And then if Mum and Dad come in and check on us, they'll think that we're in the beds.
These kids have thought of everything. Last week, they went to our workshop to meet model maker Andy Dubert and begin the first stage of making the decoy dummies.
Hello, your cheek. Puffy cheeks there. Oh, there you
fantastic.
Are.
Fantastic.
Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Off it comes.
Hey.
Well done. That's perfect. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. There we are.
And there you are.
There you are.
Andy has spent the whole week at the workshop putting the finishing touches to the dummies, and now it's time to show them to the kids. What will they think of them?
Oh my God. Can I touch it?
Yeah, of course you can.
Oh my God.
That's actually really scary.
I really like the face. It looks exactly like me.
You ready?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh my God,
I'm clever
face.
That's horrible. Oh my God. You can even poke him in the eye.
You don't want to poke your sister in the eye, do you, Matthew?
Inside, Jem and Matthew are recording a soundtrack to make the dummies even more lifelike.
Right, let's see how that's recorded.
It sounds like a pig.
Maybe that's how you snore.
Next door, us girls and the dummies are holding a pyjama party.
Tess?
Yes, Angel?
Oh!
Open this door.
It's your wardrobe. But is it really a wardrobe? Mm. Have a good rummage through. It's a secret entrance.
Oh my God.
And in the secret den, we have a state-of-the-art widescreen TV, plus a DVD player, a mini hi-fi, a microwave for those midnight snacks, a mini bar, a
a games console and a TV VCR combo.
Matthew, what do you think of your new secret den?
It is fantastic. I love it.
Girls, come on in.
Girls, this is fantastimo.
Welcome to your new playroom.
Oh my God.
Guess what? You've got your own set of headphones so you can listen to the music or watch TV or play the games console and your mum and dad won't be able to hear. So they won't know you're in here.
It's brilliant. It is so good. It's fantastic.
Is this what you imagined?
When it's
you
not, it's better.
Better.
It's better.
Is this better?
Yeah, it's way better.
I can't believe this. All the people who did this, I love them.
The finishing touches are being made to Carmen Wood, including putting up the children's initials over the new gate. You've heard of MGM Studios? Well, welcome to MNN. Mum and Dad, the guests of honour, are on their way home for the grand opening.
I'm now officially panicking. I've been quite calm the last couple of days, but it's actually dawned on me today what we might possibly find.
What they definitely will find is that their quiet house has changed into a loud villa, Hollywood style. Nicola's room has now become a den with secret entrances so the kids can sneak in after bedtime. And the kitchen has acquired an unorthodox waste disposal unit.
Okay, here goes.
Yep.
Having worked with him on the road for over 12 years, how does status quo think Dad will react?
He's a very thorough man. And when he sees the state of his house, he ain't going to believe it, I don't think.
Them kids are in deep trouble.
We're just waiting for them. They're on the way. And they're almost ready to witness the worldwide premiere of Carmen Wood.
And like all premieres, there's bound to be a few celebrity guests.
Welcome home.
Hidden away in their new den, the kids are watching events unfold.
Here comes
the
fun.
Right there. Are you ready?
As ready as I'll ever be.
After three, blindfolds off.
Got one hand on it, Andy?
Yeah,
one,
ready.
One, two, three.
Oh, my God.
Welcome to Carmen Wood. You're right, Tina.
Fantastic.
Oh, my God.
I can't believe
I like
they
the gates.
Came up.
They are definitely better.
Isn't it fantastic? Don't you think it's great?
Oh, my God. Dad
it's
likes it.
Brilliant.
No,
it's
he doesn't.
Brilliant. It is fantastic.
I'm not sure about Carmen Wood at the top.
Oh, my God. Oh, hello, everybody.
You got paparazzi.
Hello, everybody.
I should glide down the red carpet.
Hello, everybody.
Oh, you.
Oh,
you. Oh,
it's
so nice of you to make it here. Glad
you could come. Thanks very much.
I heard he wasn't exactly your favourite movie star here, but...
There's another Hugh.
It's Hugh again.
It wasn't. I didn't actually mean it, Hugh. You are a big favourite of mine, really.
Oh dear. Look at this.
Fantastic. Walk of fame.
Yeah, that is brilliant.
I can't believe he likes that.
Oh, God.
Hollywood style.
That is fantastic.
He keeps saying, oh, it's fantastic.
That is fantastic.
It's amazing. It really is.
I'm really surprised. Yeah. Pleasantly surprised.
Are you really?
Yeah,
really?
I'm not sure about the Carmen Wood, but the rest of it is great.
Oh,
I love it all, but for that, I think that,
yeah.
You can't even look at that.
Everything apart from the Carmen Wood is fantastic.
I don't like that at all.
I'm really disappointed
that you
got it.
Righty-ho, then.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Don't be shy, Sheena. It's your house.
Matthew's bedroom. That's a new cupboard.
Oh,
that cupboard definitely wasn't here when we left.
All he basically wanted was a new wardrobe. He said, I've even tied him a new wardrobe. My dad will be happy because you like him being tidy.
Like
so he's all neat and he's all tidy.
And this is all Matthew wanted, a new wardrobe?
Well, yes.
Oh, bless him.
He definitely wanted a new wardrobe. That was part of it.
Yeah.
Something doesn't feel right.
No,
something doesn't feel right, but I don't know what it is. The blue looks similar to the piece of debris that turned up at the hotel last night.
Oh, does it? Ah! Do something.
A new security lock.
Yeah.
On Nicola's door.
Is it on
do we
there?
Get to know the code or is it?
I don't know the code. So that stays locked.
That stays locked. All right.
I think the kids know the code.
All right.
Oh, there's a change here.
Oh, my God.
Well, they've decided now to share the room.
Right, yeah.
Right.
Natalie and Nicola are going to share a room.
Are you sure?
Yes.
They actually said that?
Yes. They've agreed, happily. They've shook hands on it.
Oh, God.
We'll have a look at your room.
What's that, then?
Mum, we're in here!
Get in here.
Hello.
Hi, Mum.
Oh, we love the front.
Is there a secret trapdoor somewhere?
Hello.
Oh, well, I think you've all done really well.
Meant to hate.
Yeah,
it.
Apart from the Carmen wood.
Weeks later, has the glamour of Carmenwood worn off?
The Carmenwood sign is probably my worst nightmare come true. You can see the sign from the end of the street. We've had people cruising up and down in the cars. A group of ramblers wandered down the street and took a short lunch break there outside the gate. So it's pretty much everything I didn't really want. It's made it into a kind of a tourist attraction.
With a little help from us, the kids now have a system for getting Mum and Dad out of the kitchen.
Be happy.
The food tube's really good, because now Dad and Mum don't really know about that.
Hello? Hello?
I'll never have to eat another pea again.
What's
odd? It's Matthew. Doesn't argue with them anymore because he's got nothing to argue about.
I'm impressed.
I don't know whether that will affect Matthew when he's older because he doesn't eat any vegetables at all. But it's loads better anyway.
Time for bed, you lot.
Be happy. Lay your head. Somebody came and took your bed. Don't worry.
Mum and Dad used to like control the bedtime and send us to what time they wanted, but they don't control this house anymore. They think they do, but they don't. We've definitely got power. I think Mum and Dad have realised what we could have done, so they respect us more.
I mean, I'm inclined to give them a bit more rope now, I think, where it regards to their input into the house.
We were a bit disappointed that my dad really liked it. He's quite laid back, really, if he can be laid back about that.
Don't worry, be happy.
Well, next is PC Morgan getting too close and too personal with her investigation in the dangerous world of the vice. Then later, the ITV News at 10.